In the jungles of Cambodia lie the ancient ruins of a large empire with temples and structures that are amazing to explore. Angkor Archaeological Park by Siem Reap is one of the world's largest archaeological centers with more sites than you could ever expect to visit. Join me as I introduce my favorite sites in and around this remarkable location in Southeast Asia. When I first saw pictures of the ancient jungle temples in Cambodia, I was eager to experience them for myself, and now they are one of my most cherished destination memories. Most people are only aware of its crowning monument, Angkor Wat, and don't realize the size of the area and the number of temples in the park. Although Angkor Wat is stunning, others are equally grand and somewhat more memorable in their own unique way. I'll provide you with highlights to the area and the key sites we visited, which will each have their own video in this series. We fly into Siem Reap, Cambodia. It's the gateway to Angkor Archaeological Park, which boasts magnificent structures from the 9th to the 15th centuries. This was the capital of the ancient Khmer Empire. The Khmer Empire existed for about 600 years, from 800 AD to 1430. Based in what is now Cambodia, it also encompassed parts of Thailand, Laos, and Vietnam. So while Europe was going through its medieval period with kings and castles, knights and crusades, here was an empire which is considered to have had the world's largest pre-industrial urban center. As many as 750,000 people resided here, and it covered about 400 square kilometers. It was supported by a large water management network of canals, dikes, and reservoirs, which allowed a steady water supply, providing 3 rice harvests a year, enabling the empire to flourish. The region was first introduced to the Western world in 1863, when a French explorer published articles of Angkor Wat in London and Paris. France soon followed up with numerous research teams and began a conservation effort of many of the temples and monuments to prevent their further deterioration. In 1992, the Angkor Park became a UNESCO World Heritage Site with a wide-ranging program to preserve and safeguard the sites and the surrounding area. Today, Angkor has about 23 million visitors a year, with 50 temples listed as UNESCO World Heritage Sites. We'll visit my top 5, with one being a large complex, and I'll suggest a few more activities to round out your visit. Bunte Sri may be the smallest and the oldest temple, but is the most beautiful. The hard pink sandstone quartz exterior glows in the sun, showing off intricate carvings, displaying more of an Indian-style architecture than any of the other temples. Ta Prohm is the one I was most eager to see. So mysterious and enchanting, with the jungle desperately attempting to overtake this ancient structure, its stone walls barely able to withstand the roots of the massive fig trees. And some scenes from the first Tomb Raider movie were filmed here. In a state of jungle survival and primarily left in a natural state, Phra Kon is even larger. More than just a temple, in its day it was a Buddhist university and former capital of the empire. We admire the sunrise over the region's most iconic structure. Angkor Wat, with its 3 levels and 5 massive lotus bud towers, is the empire's crowning legacy and the largest religious monument in the world. All temples in the region had a city encircling them with an impressive outer perimeter wall surrounded by a moat. Angkor Thom has massive walls surrounding the largest royal city built at the peak of the empire. It was more spacious than any walled city in medieval Europe, and has a number of structures still somewhat intact. Within this complex is the fabulous Bion Temple, its three tiers rising like a mountain with around 200 massive Buddha faces. We enjoy the setting sun while perched on an ancient temple with the highest vantage point in the park. Phnom Bekang is the most popular sunset location, with views all around, including Angkor Wat in the distance. It gets busy, so you need to come early as it's limited to 300 people. Close by is Tonle Sap Lake, the largest freshwater lake in Southeast Asia. Take a boat ride through a water village on stilts for a pleasant escape from temple touring. Visiting the Angkor Park is quite easy. The town of Siem Reap sits at its doorstep and has short, convenient flights from major centers nearby. It has become quite a tourist destination. We treated ourselves to a lovely resort, but you could also find a variety of accommodations to suit your budget. And while here, I also recommend you take in a traditional dance performance. The Apsara dance dates back to the 7th century as shown on their temple walls. It is said that the king had over 3,000 Apsara dancers in his court. So attending a show is a perfect way to further appreciate their culture and history and conclude your visit. We visited Siem Reap as a multi-day add-on excursion to our trip to Thailand, so it was a short 1-hour plane flight from Bangkok. We spent 4 nights here, allowing a full 3 days of touring, and you could easily add more time depending on your pace and what all you want to see. You'll need a pass to get into Angkor Archaeological Park, and you could purchase either a 1-day, 3-day, or 7-day passes, and they must be used on consecutive days. A 3-day pass is $37. You can hire a car and driver for about $40 a day, and your own tour guide for about an additional $30 a day. We used a car and driver with a guide for the first 2 days, and then just a car and driver for the last day. For us, it was money well spent. A tuk-tuk is about the same cost as a car or a taxi. And coming from a cooler climate, we found it very hot and humid, and we enjoyed the air conditioning of a vehicle during our long touring days. So be sure to catch my videos on each of the sites. Angkor Wat and the Water Village Boat Ride are both out now, and Banti Sri will be my next posting. Angkor beer, nice and cold. But look at the pull top on it. Isn't that cool? If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.